Is it possible to own a word? You might think the answer is no, because words are an ephemeral concept. But in the weird and complex world of trademarks, things can get a little complicated. Anyone can trademark something, technically. All you have to do is slap one of those TM symbols onto a word or phrase you want to associate with your brand. This will protect you a little bit legally, but not much. If you really want to claim a word for your own, you have to register it with the U.S. Patent and Trademark Office, which will decide if you deserve a shiny, legally binding registered trademark. There are 5 general categories for words: generic, descriptive, suggestive, arbitrary, and invented, which get progressively easier to trademark. Fish and chips would fall under generic because it is a common term for a specific product. Descriptive marks are anything that describes a product or service, which could be as straightforward as Holiday Inn. Adding a surname, like Smith's Sandwich Shop, also counts as a descriptive term and isn't as easy to trademark as you might think. In order to trademark a descriptive phrase, you have to prove that people already associate that with your brand, which can take some time. Suggestive marks are similar to descriptive marks, but more vague. One example is the suntan oil company Coppertone. The name doesn't tell you what the company sells, but it does suggest the idea of tanning. Arbitrary marks are words that don't tell you anything about what a company does, like the men's personal care company, Axe. Lastly are invented marks, like Google, which are the easiest to trademark because they don't compete with anything that already exists. And in case that sounds a little too simple, don't worry, the fight over words can get pretty heated. In many cases, big companies will sue smaller ones anytime they sense possible trademark infringement. Facebook might sue any small company that tries to launch using face or book in their name, like they did with Teachbook in 2011. But usually this gets settled outside of court because small companies want to avoid a lengthy legal process. When both companies involved are big, though, the fight can stretch on. There was a decades-long war over the word Apple, waged between 2 companies: Apple Computers, which created the iPhone, and Apple Corp, which owns all of the Beatles' music. It was finally decided in 2007 that because they offer such different services, they could both keep calling themselves Apple. And sometimes companies will try to trademark words or phrases that they probably shouldn't. In 2013, Disney tried to register Dia de los Muertos and its English counterpart, Day of the Dead, to promote an upcoming film. This unsurprisingly angered the many people who celebrate the holiday, and the company eventually backed down, but it shows that there can be a dark side to letting companies own certain words and phrases. On the more entertaining side of things, many trademarks are celebrity catchphrases. Paris Hilton successfully reached a settlement with Hallmark when they tried to use her catchphrase, "That's hot," on one of their cards. And Hilton is far from alone. Phrases from Emeril Lagasse's Bam to Taylor Swift's This Sick Beat have become registered trademarks. And there are also a lot of trademarked words out there you might not even realize are owned by a specific company because they've gone through genericization, meaning that a brand's term is now used by people as a stand-in for what the product is actually called. Velcro, Band-Aid, Frisbee, and even the word popsicle are all protected, so if you want to sell frozen treats on a stick, you have to call them ice pops or something else. Trademarks, both registered and not, are really only important for brands to keep in mind. You can't be charged for simply saying the word Google aloud, at least not yet. But pulling back the curtain on trademark law shows just how much our modern lives are shaped by the products we consume. Thank you.